Welcome to Crossroads Podcast, an SIBKL production.
I think the key thing is why?
Yeah.
Why do you want to start a relationship? If those who are single, why do you honestly want to start a relationship? Is it to fulfill a void, you know, of loneliness because you feel that, family background, you know, it's so broken, like you feel that you're not loved in the family, and then you want to start a relationship because you just want a guy or a girl to fulfill that void. Yeah, and I think by starting a relationship with that manner, I think it might not lead to a good ending because it did not start with a right principle, if I can put it that way. And to me, this is something I believe, that, you know, relationship comes from God, and that the reason why we start a relationship or we want to go into a relationship, we need to factor in the God part. Is God in this relationship? Because this is how I grew up. Okay, I'm not sure about you. I grew up having a list of the kind of girl. Okay, it must. Okay, take away all the default thing, lah. Okay, love God, others. I think that's a given. But okay, like this, like that, like this kind of thing. Then from there, as you grow, there's, oh yeah, this one cannot. I delete a bit. This one cannot. I delete a bit. Okay, so I grew up with that mindset in that sense, and only come to about recently, actually, I come to a point that I might not want to use a list anymore. Not for me, when I share to other people. Because you see, when we come to a list, we put what we want.
Yeah.
And then, of course, we will delete along the way. And then we will ask God, this is my list. Can you help me show me the person that looks like this? All right. And then it came a point, Tyrisa, I was just listening to a sermon. Someone was sharing and saying that, you know, when we put our list, sometimes we limit God to want to fulfill this list that we want. But actually, God has his own list for you. That by putting a list there, we will say, God, help me fulfill this. I will fast and pray you fulfill. I'm willing to minus all this. I just need that one thing only. Can or not? Can you follow? Can you help me with that? But I think it's just a revelation that, you know, sometimes God wants to just give us the person or even give us the season to be single or to be with someone that this is my list for you. Are you willing to take my list? Or are you so adamant on holding that list that you have? Because this is something, maybe I heard it before, that people say, hey, why are you so picky? You already. Why are you still so picky? Just take, there's so many fish in the sea, take one. Right? So maybe, I'm not sure, maybe for some of us here, maybe some people listening as well, maybe they're holding on to their list, their own list for a long time, and not willing to tear that list and ask God, just give me your list. I think cukup already. Give me your list. Yeah. I'm not sure. Do you have a list? Or do you currently have a list and looking like, you know, checking and all that?
I think maybe it's about 10 years ago. My mom read a book and say, you know, if you want to have God to give you a husband, right, you must have a list. And I'm just like, so what? Like a shopping list, is it? Like if I don't have this list, that God won't know what I want. Then just for me, I couldn't compute this at all, you know. So to answer your question, honestly, I don't have a list.
Okay.
Is that why?
But I did catch out some people. I say, what's your list? The person is just need to be alive and walking.
And obviously of the opposite gender. I mean to be very clear, right? So I think I want to really bring it as a single person who doesn't have a list. Right. I really wonder sometimes, is it my fault that because I don't have a list, I don't know what I want, ma?
Okay.
And that's why that it just keeps, the cycle just keeps going, you know. I think right now they call it the ick factor.
Okay.
Yeah, so that because you just have to go through this person, keep seeing this person until you get the ick.
Okay.
Where you feel like, ew, I cannot already, like, no, I cannot date this guy, or I cannot date this girl. But again, it's been such a process. It's been such a process because I think going back to what you're talking about, right, it's like seasons. It's a season of marriage. I would even believe that marriage is a season because once your spouse passes away, the season of this particular marriage is over, isn't it?
That's true.
Yeah.
That's true.
But what about, I think a lot of the fear on a lot of single people's mind what if it's not a season?
Okay.
What if it's not a season? What if this is really
who you are meant to be?
Yeah. Like what if this is the rest of my life, right? Mm. I think I don't know why the world is so obsessed with terms. I just found out this term recently. It's called incel. Basically, okay. involuntarily celibate. Means that I desire to be with someone, but it's just not happening. So it's not like because I choose to be celibate, it's just not happening, right? Mm. And I think this fear is very predominant in our minds.
Mm.
That what if it's not a season? It is forever. And I think if I could even reflect as a single person, I mean, I really believe that God knows best.
Mm.
I really believe that God knows best. He knows what's best for me. And that's why I go back to the whole ministry of the single and ministry of the marriage. Because when I get married, it is possible that I won't be able to have biological children because of my age, right? Mm-hmm. Or even for whoever's listening, if you are above a certain age, this will definitely cross your mind, right? Like
that's the reality.
That's the reality. That's over. It's like that's over, right? So what would my marriage be about, right? And I have friends who are such model couples, but obviously they have children and model couples who are like they really really believe in godly marriages.
Mm.
Yeah, but I still cannot find myself fitting to this because I'm single. Okay. I'm not married. Mm. And I think I'm going to do a plug-in. I'm going to just share about what I caught when God was what I was processing this.
Mm. Okay.
Before I even said yes to coming to this podcast, I'm like, why do I want to talk about my dirty, in a way, my past failures? I mean, technically, if you're not married, those are failures. Right.
Okay. In a sense,
right.
Okay.
And I think I was editing Hot Seat, and then Pastor Lee Chu and Pastor Lee Chu spoke about her relationship with Pastor Chu and how she talked about submission, about covering, about how in a partnership, you know, together they built SIBKL for the last 30 years.
Yeah.
And as a single person who listens to this, they're like, oh, that's well and good, you know, but what about me?
Mm.
So same as when I was editing, I had the same thought. I think as a, so I in my profession, I've been a wedding photographer for the last 10 years. So okay. I am at a lot of weddings. I shoot a lot of weddings. So it is also a very awkward situation where I think it's also a reminder that how success and still here, failure, right? Okay. Because I'm still single and
at the back of
your mind. And then I think God was so gracious to me, and he reminded me of what in especially for Christian weddings, what is the main message when the pastor or the priest talks about marriage.
Mm.
And I think the big word is always covenant.
Mm.
Right?
Well,
covenant. Yep. And I think God, since I'm not married, does it mean that I have no covenant? That I don't have to submit to anyone. I don't have a covering of anyone, right? Yeah. And God says, who says?
Mm.
He said to me, doesn't my covenant with you stand?
Mm.
Don't I have a covenant with you?
Mm.
Then for me, I just literally stopped right there, right? And I realized, yes.
Mm.
Even though I am not married, I don't have a covenant with another person.
Mm.
But God still keeps his promises to me.
Mm.
And literally, it's the same as the vows, till death do us part.
Mm-hmm.
But the thing about covenant with God, that literally death is not the end.
Yeah, yeah.
And that is it even surpasses human covenant.
Mm. Yeah, that's true.
I think as a single person of my age, that brought me comfort because it means, I think ultimately, if you ask any woman, right, why do you want to get married? Why do you want to get married? Of course, like have children. And then I think one of the biggest word that women would give is security.
Mm.
Being safe.
Yeah, that's a very good thing.
Yeah, being safe, right? That we want to be protected.
Mm.
And as a single woman, you feel so unprotected in that way. Because financially, you're on your own.
Okay.
Unless you stay with your parents. Or like it, and then generally your life, you're alone, right? Mm. Whether you're not a single man or single woman. But if God says to a single woman or single man, my covenant is with you, it means I will be your safety. Mm. I will be your security. Yeah. I will protect you, that you are literally not alone. You're like, even though there's no one who's standing on earth, who's standing in that place for on behalf of me.
Yeah, yeah, that's right.
But doesn't mean I am not doing it for you.
Mm, wow.
So that for me, I was like, that really just...
That's a very deep revelation though. I think that's very good, because at the end, it comes back to the question, why do you want to be in a relationship?
Yes.
Like, because if it's just purely about your own personal longing of just not wanting to be alone, I think the one that you spoke about, covenant, that, you know, we shouldn't jump into a relationship just because we want someone to fulfill that void. There must be a deeper reason, a God reason in that sense. Let me move on a little bit to people who are in a relationship.
Yeah.
Okay, so like now in a relationship, or maybe people who are seeking to be in a relationship, I think that the very important thing is this, that just because we're in a relationship at this point of time, because I think the word relationship, there's just so many categories, from just about dating, wanting to get married, or already married. I think the very important question is this: is God in that relationship? You know, are we pushing certain boundaries? You know, for those of us, maybe for just about to date, you know, maybe where is the boundaries? It's just that our purpose for dating is just for the sake of, let's just try. And then we don't have certain boundaries. What's the purpose of the relationship then? Is it just self-fulfilling, self-preservation, self-indulgence, or whatever words you can use? I think, because I believe, you see, relationship between a man and a woman is something that is very sacred. It's something that is given by God. You know, God has created for man and woman to be together naturally. And with that, there's an element of sacredness in that. And if we take out that sacredness in that sense to make it like, tes ya, tes des saja lah, I think we have taken away a beautiful essence of what God created marriage for. Yeah. So I think for all of us in a relationship, some people say I'm in a toxic relationship and all those. I think it's very hard to define what is a toxic relationship per se. I'll just ask that question, is God in that relationship? And for me, why I chose to be in a relationship, in that sense, for my own story, is because it was very clear. Because for me, I knew that my journey was to go into full-time ministry as a children pastor, in that sense. I knew that I needed a partner that can journey with me so that I can do better in the ministry. The mindset was, so one very important list, if I can put it that way at the point of time, is that this person must acknowledge that I'm going full-time and must love children. We must do these two things together. And if just say this person comes in and it takes away more time from me fulfilling the call that God has for me, that I know 110% this person is not right for me. And Felicia felt that principle that I held very well, and that she actually helped me a lot in the sense of ministry. It helped me a lot in knowing myself better. And I felt this is the God purpose. There's, yes, companionship is one, but companionship not just for myself, but for the call that God has given me. Yeah, so I think coming to this whole big picture of relationship. Yeah, so I think that there's so many categories. So singlehood, people who are now in the season of I'm waiting. Some people are in a season of I'm not waiting anymore. I think I'm just satisfied with where I am
I'm
right
just
now.
Done.
I'm just done enough with all this. Some of us who are married. I think so. There's so many categories of relationship. I think something I just want to slowly conclude is that, what is the purpose of you, of us, even for myself, I need to remind myself, of being in this current season that you are in, singlehood, wanting to start and all that. What's the purpose? If you want to start, what's the purpose? If you are saying that I want to be single, is it just a defense mechanism to say that, forget it? Or is it something that God has placed in your heart that I'm calling you to be like this so that you can fulfill certain things? Because this, at the end of the day, God has given us a prophetic destiny in our life. And a partner there would definitely help us in certain things. But it does not mean that a person who is single, you are incomplete. because I generally hear this a lot, that this is my other half. I don't really like that term in that sense, because I feel that you are complete by yourself.
Yep.
You don't need another person to complete you. But if God gives you another person, it's 200%, two full person coming together. Two become one. The Bible didn't say half and half become one. It's two become one. So that's something I really believe, that at the end of the day, for all of us, what's the purpose? Know your purpose of where you are in today, and that if you are in a relationship, like for myself and for you, I believe one day, you know, we trust God, that I pray that your relationship is one that glorifies God. And you know, if you're listening, you know if your relationship is glorifying God or not.
Mm.
Are we pushing certain physical boundaries with each other when we know it's not time yet? You know, even for those who are married, you know, are we taking advantage of our spouses or even our children? Yeah, because at the end of the day, if God is in the center, everything that we do in our season must honor God. I think that's the beauty about relationship, because coming back to the whole Trinity, God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit, all of them automatically have a concept of honoring each other. From the beginning of time, all they have a concept of loving each other. All of them had an idea that everything they do is together. It was never that, oh, you do this. It's something that is a united front. So as a family, I believe we must always come united under the covering of God. That's the most important thing. And for those who are looking to start a relationship, start well with the right mindset. And I just want to caution, don't just start because, let's try lah. Or just start because, I think I'm the right age, maybe I should just like someone. I think we are created to be beings with much more value than that. Let's see God in our relationship lah. Because at the end of the day, we hear this many times, Jeremiah 29 verse 11. For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord, plans to prosper you, give you a hope and a future. It's not to harm you. We sometimes as Christians, we easy to say, hard to follow.
Yep.
Now, I know it's not easy, especially maybe for some of you, oh, Jeremy, you are married, yeah, it's okay, lah. There's nothing in that. But there are certain struggles in marriage as well.
Yeah.
That's why divorce happens. Yeah, it's not to say once you're married, it's full stop. You know, there's a whole new arena of why people get divorced, abuse.
Yeah.
It's like a business partner. The husband and wife has become a business partner where they're here, their business, their project is the children. They fulfill the things that they need, they provide for the children, they just make sure the children are safe, but both of them have no real love relationship. And because sometimes maybe God has been removed, not something else has come in. So I think at the end of the day, why? Why do you want to be in a relationship? So as we come to a close, we believe that God holds our future. Yeah, and let's not rush into something when we are not ready. Yeah, like for you, I believe you, although you are still looking for a relationship, but there's no urgency that I better do. Yes, although the whole starting a family thing, but this is actually something I've told people before, that, you know, creation comes from God. If God decides to give you a baby, even though you could be in the 40s, for example, and you find someone, can't God just give you a baby? Because whatever we gave is just a very scientific thing. It's man-made. Who did God ever say that you cannot have a baby after 40? So I think if we take away that, like, let's look at a God list, because that was a very my list. I cannot have a baby by then, but God said, I'm the creator. Why you limit yourself to your list? If I want to give, I will give. You can try whatever you want. If I give, I'll give. So I think that's something to just, I do not know if that makes sense to you, but it's something to hold, to throw away your list, our list, whatever list that we have, even for family, that we want children to be successful and all those are good lists. But at the end of the day, where is the list that God is giving you in this relationship? Because we are also in a relationship covenant with God in that sense. So yeah, Jeremiah 29 verse 11. This just gave me a deeper meaning of that. Anything to say, Cheryl? I mean, after all this, whatever you share. Again, thank you so much for sharing your heart. I think that's really honest of you, and you really made yourself very vulnerable. So thank you so much. Any final thoughts with regard this to this whole relationship?
I think if I could say one last thing is that I, in general, don't feel, if I could say it, it don't feel like it's your fault that that you are not getting what you want. I mean, because I think it's so easy to say, I'm not pretty enough, I'm not smart enough. But I think for women, it's more of like, I'm not hot enough lah. You know what I mean? And I think that I had to go through that experience to understand my worth. And I really believe that if I had walked into a relationship at that moment of time, I think I would have used that relationship to define my worth from the start till the end. And that person will break me and not make me. And I think it's a reminder how I think thank you, Pastor Jeremy, for saying all this. I also want to acknowledge that loneliness is real. I think loneliness is real. It's such a strong emotion, a strong feeling that a single person has, lah.
Yeah.
And I think if I could say this, is to always keep yourself in community. Community who loves you, not community who highlights your flaws, but community that loves you, who wants the best for you, and can also still accept you even though you are unattached.
Yeah.
And I think for married people, I know I've had the, how come you not married yet, pastor lah? You know what I mean? But I think single people get it all the time. I will say to the married people, pray for your single friends, really. I think instead of nagging us, pray for us. And I think blind dates is still a thing. go for it. I mean, like, if you find someone, a friend of another single friend of yours who you feel would match this other friend, just do it. Just set up on a blind date and see what happens. Because who knows, God will also use you to also set something up, because we are all limited, we're all busy. And again, online is not the only way to get a partner. I really believe that through loving community, through church, through friends, I think a partner can be found from there as well.
Sure. I think in a nutshell, as we close this podcast coming to an end, don't be afraid. I think first thing, don't be afraid, but know why. Know the why. Don't just do it for the sake of doing it. Don't start a relationship for the sake of doing it. And if you're in a relationship, don't just do relationship without a purpose of why you are with this person. Why has God given you this spouse in that sense? So always know the why. And I agree with that. As a church, I think because now we are talking about taboos in church, right? Let's learn to show love to each other. We know some of them are struggling. Those who are looking for someone, there's a certain nerve when you ask them, why you don't want to get married? They want. I believe they really want. Generally speaking, everybody wants that. Let's learn to love each other and speak in a different manner to encourage them rather than putting them down, because they're already hurt in that sense.
Yeah.
And even for people who are married, you know, relationship, they say, hey, where's your first kid? You married it. Where's your kids?
Oh, yeah.
Where's your second kid? After you get first one, where's your second? Where's your third? You know, everybody has a different season that you might not know. But sometimes our words can kill people. Yeah, so I think as a church, that we don't want to make dating as something so taboo that I'm so scared. Yes, there are consequences that comes with it, the awkwardness. Yeah, but I believe dating in church should be a very safe place, and it should be done in a very sacred manner. That it's not just changing of like clothes like that. You know, it should be done in a proper way. So thank you so much for joining us today for this podcast. Once again, Cheryl, thank you so much for sharing your heart. Again, please, for those of you listening, we are not highlighting any individuals. I think this is just a very vulnerable story that both of us are sharing. And I pray that at the end of the day, the take home from this is that you're not alone. You have friends, you have pastors that are here. If you are in any particular ministry, talk to your pastors, be accountable to them. If you are struggling in a relationship, if you are looking for a relationship, anything. I believe that's the whole purpose of why we are here in different crossroads of our life, making certain decisions. So, and we are here for you. The church is here for you. Talk to us. So, thank you so much for joining us today. See you for our next episode. Bye.
Bye.
Thank you for tuning in. If you enjoyed this episode, subscribe for more Crossroads content. Look forward to new episodes every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. If you need to speak to a pastor or if you're looking for a church to call home, come visit SIBKL.
Come talk to us at Presence Conference.
This September!